Good afternoon. I want to speak directly to you today because Canada is at a crossroads. Je sais que la lutte contre la COVID-19 a été difficile pour tous les Canadiens.
19 has been difficult for all Canadians in the last 6 months. For too many people, it's a question of life or death. And for all of us collectively, it is the fight of our generation. In the spring, we all worked together to flatten the curve, and our efforts have borne fruit. But now, the virus is gaining new ground in a number of regions of the country.
The second wave isn't just starting. It's already underway. The numbers are clear. Back on March 13th, when we went into lockdown, there were 47 new cases of COVID-19. Yesterday alone, we had well over 1,000. We're on the brink of a fall that could be much worse than the spring. I know this isn't the news that any of us wanted to hear. And we can't change today's numbers or even tomorrow's. Those were already decided by what we did or didn't do 2 weeks ago. But what we can change is where we are in October and into the winter. It's all too likely we won't be gathering for Thanksgiving, but we still have a shot at Christmas. Together, we have the power to get this second wave under control. I know we can do it because we've already done it once before. In the spring, we all did our part by staying home. And this fall, we have even more tools in the toolbox. People are wearing masks. That's critical. So keep it up. We've got the COVID Alert app. Take the teacher who felt fine, but who tested positive after the app warned her she'd been exposed. COVID Alert meant she went home instead of the classroom. It's a powerful, free tool that's easy to use and protects your privacy. So if you haven't already, download it off the App Store or Google Play. It's one more way to keep ourselves and others safe. Another is to get your flu shot this fall. Les gestes qu'on pose aujourd'hui,
our actions today will make all the difference in what happens 2 weeks or 2 months from now. Wear a mask. It saves lives. Wash your hands. Keep your distance from others. Get a flu shot. Listen to public health advice. As Dr. Tam said yesterday, limit your social circle. Avoid taking risks that are not necessary. This is no time for parties. No one is invincible. Neither are your loved ones. We cannot let our guard down now, even in those places where the number of cases is still low. And everyone, please, download the COVID Alert application. It's easy and free. It protects your privacy. And this is something that will protect you and the people around you.
This is the time for all of us as Canadians to do our part for our country, as government does its part for you. There is a covenant between government and the people government serves. You need to know that you can rely on us, just like you can rely on each other. Alors qu'on fait face à cette crise, alors qu'on
s'apprête à rebâtir, as we face this crisis and prepare to rebuild, we will continue to be there for you. The government presented a plan that rests on four foundations to address this crisis. The first thing we must do is protect the health of Canadians. The actions of our parents and our grandparents, those of the generation that faced the Great Depression and World War II, remind us that we must be resilient and patient in times of crisis. They build today's world, and now it's up to us to build the world of tomorrow, beginning by protecting them. The situation experienced by too many elders in our long-term care homes is unacceptable. That has to change, and it will change. In the spring, we sent in the Army to assist, and the Red Cross is still on the ground. We will be working right away with the provinces and territories to set new national standards on long-term care.
Job one is keeping people safe. That's why we're signing deals on multiple potential vaccines, on therapeutics, on personal protective equipment, In fact, because we mobilized this spring, Canadians are now producing almost every type of PPE we need. We're helping the provinces and territories ramp up their capacity on testing while creating a federal response team for surge demand. And as soon as there's approval for faster tests to be used safely, we'll get them out across the country. If you need a test, you should be able to get one and get it quickly. This is about safety, and it's about what's right for Canadians. Protecting your health is the best thing we can do for the economy. So that's what we're working on first. And that brings me to the second part of the plan, supporting Canadians through this pandemic. The federal government will have your back, whatever it takes, to help you get through this crisis. Maybe you were one of the almost 9 million people who used the Canada Emergency Response Benefit this spring. We will continue to support all those who need it with a strengthened and broadened employment insurance system. Maybe your boss was able to keep you on the job or hire you back because the emergency wage subsidy helped with the payroll. People still need this program, so we're extending it right through to next summer. Or perhaps you're a business owner needing extra help to bridge to better times. For you, among other measures, we're expanding the Canada Emergency Business Account. And there's a lot more we're going to do. Go to canada.ca/coronavirus to see what support is available right now and how to apply. I know some people are asking how we can afford to do all this for Canadians. That's fair. Low interest rates mean we can afford it. And in fact, doing less would end up costing far more. Doing less would mean a slower recovery and bigger deficits in the long run. While we're dealing with this pandemic, I don't want you or your parent or your friend to take on debt that your government can better shoulder. So yes, in the short term, we'll keep investing. But beyond the emergency, as we start to build back better, we must do that in a fiscally and sustainable way. Investing for our recovery must be done responsibly. Vous savez, la pandémie.
You know, the pandemic has laid bare fundamental inequalities in our society. But now we have an opportunity to act to change that. We will build a better society for all by also building a better economy for all. In fact, this is the third foundation of the government's approach.
By creating a Canada-wide early learning and child care system, we'll ensure that kids have access to care and that no parent, especially no mother, has to put their career on hold. This pandemic has reminded us all that building strong social supports is essential to growing the economy. By accelerating progress on national universal pharmacare, we'll get people the medicine they need while alleviating pressure on the healthcare system.
By investing to eliminate chronic homelessness, we will create communities that are healthy and more prosperous. Housing is not just a problem, it's also a solution. It creates jobs. It allows people to thrive and contribute. We all want to build a stronger country for everyone. To do that, though, we must redouble our efforts to fight climate change. That is also the best way to ensure there are good jobs for today and for tomorrow.
Energy workers innovating to decarbonize, auto workers building zero-emission vehicles, engineers and construction workers delivering green retrofits for our homes and buildings. These are some of the people who will create a competitive economy of the future. As we do this work, protecting people's health, supporting Canadians, building back better, we can't forget what it's all for, making sure that everyone can participate to their full potential. And that's the final part of the plan. As a country, we must keep making progress on reconciliation with Indigenous peoples and on fighting systemic racism. Diversity is not just our strength, it's our competitive edge. Nos différences nous enrichissent.
Our differences enrich us, whatever the color of our skin, our beliefs, our culture, or our language. In our country, we are proud to have two official languages, French and English, that we will continue to protect. In Canada, we know that we are stronger when we're united and when we help each other. We face the challenges together, and that is what has helped us to manage the crisis better than many others.
This is not the first time our country has been called to stand united and strong. In the face of change, our greatest generation showed us that overcoming crisis isn't easy. They didn't give up, and neither can we. To parents feeling like you can't get your life under control, to kids wondering why mom and dad can't just fix this, to seniors feeling like there's nothing you can do and thinking about all the things you can't do, that's understandable. But can't will not define us. We can bend the curve. We can build a stronger future. We can define the change. Les Canadiens, on est des gens qui disent,
we Canadians are people that say, I can do it. In every sector, in every corner of this country, every single one of us are doing our part. The story of this pandemic is the story of people making sacrifices, people who work hard every day to be there for each other. And it's especially the story of our frontline workers, heroes right across this country who never hesitated, who have always faced every challenge head on. You are a source of inspiration for all of us. We are at a crossroads, and the future is in our hands.
There are many days to go before we get to the other side of this, but there are also many of us to get us there, so long as we each remember to do our part. And I know that we will. We are Canadians, and together, there's nothing we can't do. Prenez soin de vous, mes amis.
Take care of yourselves, friends. Thank you.